Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. I'm joined today by a guest by the name of Russ Dizdar. He's an ordained minister, former police chaplain, and occult satanic crimes. And Russ, before the break, John, I don't know if you're in the studio, you can hear me.
I want to make sure that Russ is able to hear me, and I'm able to hear him good. But yeah, Russ, before the break, I was asking you a question about, you know, the crime scenes. If you could describe, this is a short segment here, about 5 minutes or so. But if you can describe what the, what a crime scene looked like when you first started in this field, if you will, you know, what was it that you seen?
Well, sure. I can. Well, I'll give two quick ones. One, a 13-year-old girl that we had to go visit in the psych ward. She eventually led us to a barn down in a kind of secluded area. The most that we found there was a dog that had been ritually used in the back of a barn area. Now, that was just, you know, something very slight, but she had remembered where they took her and what occurred. Now, another one of these crime scenes was a bigger, broader one. Two girls were killed, one on satanic revels, one on demon revels. Both girls, well, in the area, there was a green small gas building where they had two bloody handprints. Whether that was paint or blood, we weren't sure at the beginning. But it said sacrifice tonight. And then there was a sign a little bit further away. It said, two must die. Now, the scenes there were afterwards where the girls that had been stabbed 70, 80, 90 times, sexually, ritually abused, and then killed. You know, you're talking about very horrific crime scenes. In other cases, you have one that we had gotten involved with where the same thing, stabbed over 100 times, sexually abused in a ritual called the Hands of Glory in September, but the hands were cut off in the end. And law enforcement here in Akron has never found, they've never found the hand. So they're pretty horrific. And you know, when you look at some of these crimes, you have to look at, is a tongue cut out? Is a hand, you know, a left hand cut off? Is there symbols carved into the body? And was it done on a big issue is, was it done on a ritual date? They're pretty horrific, Sean, to talk about and to say, including little kids.
I can only imagine. You know, what are some of the and real quick side note, my studio, I can hear, I'm getting sound in my headphones. Russ, what are some of the you said, you mentioned dates and things like that. What are some things of significance, like tongue cut out and what significance is that if the left hand is cut off?
Sure. Well, there's a left-hand path issue. There's also like a tongue being cut up. It may have to do with they told. This was somebody who began to tell the secrets. There's also a thing called the satanic justice symbol that could be carved into or burned into the body. And so in again, criminalistics, law enforcement, you're looking for motivations and you're looking for what's there. What if you find black candles or green candles or a pentagram? What if you find these strange-looking languages written in a circle around the body, or an altar that has knives, candles, and so forth. So you got to look at a number of things, but then what we did know back in the 80s, late 80s, early 90s, the calendar, there's actual specific dates that major rituals are done. Now, you can go on the web and you can find that, the satanic written and ritual abuse calendar. Anybody can look it up now. You'll see the numbers of rituals. We have one that's going to occur tonight. They just had, well, purchased one the 25th of this month. We have one of our workers is interacting with a victim up north of me because they're going to be taken to this ritual, and they're trying to, you know, get them help. And it's this one tonight is Eichstack. It is going to involve blood ritual, whereas the 25th involved human sacrifice. Many of them deal with just sexual rituals, blood rituals, animal rituals. Each one is for different purposes. But the astounding numbers of them, Sean, is the big thing we can talk about at some point, because sure. The growth of the numbers of victims, when you take one step back, who created the victims are the ones who have handed down the ancient rituals and are involving them, and they're in every single state and in every single city in the United States.
Wow, that's amazing. You answered the question I was going to ask, like, where specifically are these things taking place? But you answered it. We're going to take a break, and then when we come back, we have more time. I want you to expand on some of the things that you mentioned. But in addition to that, this satanic ritual abuse, you mentioned some dates as well. I want to tie that into some previous interviews that I've had with people that have been programming that were in the occult. We'll be right back. This is Floor of Wisdom. Listening to Floor of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. The toll-free number to call in is 1-877-300-7645. That's 877-300-7645. My guest, Russ Dizdar, ordained minister, joining us talking about occult satanic crimes. Russ, before the break, you mentioned quite a few things, and I thought it's very interesting because the reason why I've interviewed previous guests numerous times on this show that were programmed, that were in the occult. And I, booking you for this interview today, I researched and listened to some previous interviews you've done. And something that I want to talk about coming up later on in the show is the fact about programming people and mind control. But before we get into that, talk a little bit more about the satanic ritual abuse that you were mentioning. You said that there are dates. There's a satanic ritual calendar. Today is a date that involves rituals. What are some of these things that, because we need to expose these things, because let's just think. Someone could be listening to this show live right now in whatever city you're listening to it in. And could be going through some things right now and are trying to get out. They don't know how to get out. Or someone knows someone that's going through some things or may notice some things about a personal friend of theirs. And it's kind of sticking out to them. And, what are some things that people need to look for that could be in being abused in a satanic with rituals involved?
Sure, thanks. There's many that have been, eventually become aware that something's wrong. They hear voices inside, they have dreams, they have missing time, and they begin to go to counselors and then begin all of what's been going on from the inside begins to come out. Now, as we track this, and we've got 30 years or more tracking it, dealing with the healing of it, going backwards, here's in all the cases of satanic ritual abuse, in all of them, it begins with selection prior to birth, where the individuals that are going to create the baby are pretty much spiritually, demonically, satanically, in the dark sense, selected to breed and then to have to be bred into the coven system, into the system. So we might look at it as satanic and evil and wrong and all this. Getting their mindset, they look at it as they're creating a superior race. By having a mother and father, that are part of this whole thing, they believe they have pure blood. That is, in our view, would be charged, demonically empowered, bloodline where the mom and dad then create, or the man and woman, they don't even have to be married, create another offspring. That offspring is considered and called a chosen one or a select one. They are there are rituals that are done prior to the actual act of sexual act. There are rituals that are done while the fetus is in the womb to try to demonize the fetus. To, if you think in terms, and again, their terms, whether we believe this or not, they believe they're kind of injecting dark presence and power into the development of DNA. They want an altered, in their view, a superior being, very much like the Hitler, because this all goes back to Hitler and Himmler and the creation of master race. All of modern-day satanic ritual abuse goes back to that very, that's the origin. So with the tens of thousands of victims and maybe some that are listening right now, the origins of this is that they were born into it. They were meant to be altered from the beginning. The satanic view, the Luciferian view, they believe they're heightening them. They're creating a superior human. Now, this will involve, you know, the demonization in the selection, then the forced, the trauma. Everybody knows that multiple personality disorder, or what they call now DID, dissociative identity disorder, that's all caused by trauma. You literally split the personality, and you create a sub-personality. Then you create another one and another one. Now, in the splitter programmer's job, they're to not only split and create the altered sub-personality, they then program it, begin to tell it what it's going to be, begin to give it a name, and they devise an entire agenda for one other sub-personality. The best way to think of it is watching a hypnotist on television when they hypnotize somebody and make them do something that they actually don't even know they're doing. Well, right. This is permanent. They're creating an altered state with a sub-personality. And then ultimately, Sean, they demonize personality. They train that one up through the years. They can be trained, created and programmed and demonized to carry out rituals, to carry out assassination, to carry out sexual, you know, things. Yeah. You can have hundreds of sub-personalities in one person.
They've actually shown this on TV about the hypnosis, putting people under a particular spell, not even knowing what they've been programmed to do, and then they've been, you know, hypnotized to carry out a particular act when triggered by whatever it is, a word, a phrase, whatever it is that they decide to come up with to trigger that person to carry out that act. You know, all this is interesting, and I've had guests on that shared stories with me, you know, similar to what you're saying, as far as their father was a full-blown Luciferian, and just full-blown Satanist, followed the doctrine of Luciferianism, and took the child, they were a child at that time, and had them perform just horrible sexual acts on them, broke them down mentally, you know, and then reprogrammed them to a different personality. And you're explaining it a lot better, you know, to give understanding, I guess, to create this multiple personality. Do they do this in the military, which I'm pretty certain of the answer. But if so, what is it that, you know, can you share how this is tied into the military and what they're doing with some of our troops involving MK Ultra?
Absolutely. And it's a vital issue because very secretive programs within the originally in the CIA and it has gone into other departments in U.S. military. Now, there's no question in Monarch, MK Ultra and numbers of the projects, you know, the victims on a military, dealt with military victims that have come to us. So we've engaged in every single one of them. They have highly, highly trained assassin shooter personalities that are extremely trained and versed in weapons and so forth. Now, I know that there's been a lot of, you know, like we look at Holmes that did the shootings at the Aurora Theater in Colorado. We look at Jared. We look from a distance. Now, I don't have them in front of me, but from a distance, I see them, without question, having all the marks of that the sub-personalities that were created, that were programmed, were the ones that did the actual shootings and killings. And then when it was over, instead of, usually they have suicide programming, but they didn't kill themselves, they got caught. And then, you know, the next day, the sub-personality goes down, the main person comes back, and they have no cognitive memory. Even if you do a lie detector test, they have no memory in the main or the personality that did not do the actual crime, shooting. So in U.S. military, and here's the big factor, it's not just speculation, it's not conspiracy. The whole issue of Manchurian Candidate goes all the way back to 1943, 1945, when the then considered worldwide renowned psychologist G.H. Estabrooks Now, he was hired by U.S. military. He was world-renowned, I believe, in the evil way, but he was world-renowned. He was the head of the Psychological Association. He has written many books. I got a hold of one of his books. I got two copies of it now. You can barely get them. In one of the chapters, the title of the book is Hypnosis, but in one chapter, he describes the weaponization, and he details how they learned how to create sub-personalities, multiple personalities in U.S. soldiers, to where the main would be split, and they would create a separate personality inside of him, and that he would not, that he would be amnesic. He didn't know that he had this. So the handlers or programmers that would do this in military would create inside of them another personality. Now, again, not my information, but G.H. Estabrooks, hired by U.S. military, describes in that chapter, Sean, that they were successful at doing it, creating sub-personalities that could be programmed and given a code. They could make assassin shooters. They could make reconnaissance agents, spies, sub-personalities that would be spies. They can create sub-personalities and send the person in to sow disinformation. So this is all explained by a U.S. military-hired psychologist in the project. So we hear about MKUltra, you know, Monarch and all that kind of stuff, but if you step back a little further and look at the content of this one individual, he describes not only that they became successful at doing military, but in that chapter, he says what we need to do is create these kind of super soldiers in all departments of U.S. military, so that in the future we can have a fifth column of hidden super soldiers. That's in G.H. Estabrooks' book called Hypnotism on the Weaponization of the Process, published in 1947. They absolutely knew how to do this all the way back then.
Russ, recently I've been covering the topic of targeted individuals. I don't know if you're familiar with this or not, but you know, the people that are coming out speaking that you know, that they're being gang stalked and they're being targeted, they're being attacked with low frequency waves, electromagnetic waves, and you know, weapons that can't be seen. Do you think that has a part of this whole satanic element of the military, or is this something totally different?
No, I think it's all a part of the same, because again, when you go to the roots of it, Himmler and Hitler was, you know, the real history tells us in the World War II, the real history shows that they wanted to create a master race of, so they began a selection process, and they had a secret project called Lebensborn to create hundreds and thousands selectively bred that would they would back them to become the Aryans, or we've heard the term the God Men.
Right, so hang tight, Russ. I'm sorry.
Way back there.
Yeah, this is really good. We got to take a quick break. This is really getting deep. His website is shatterthedarkness.net. We'll be right back on Floor of Wisdom. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. My website is flowofwisdom.com. Toll-free number to call is 877-300-7645. Stick around, because hour two, we're going to continue this discussion. But not only that, we're going to go a little deeper than what we've already covered thus far. My guest, Russ Dizdar, his website is shatterthedarkness.net. Shatterthedarkness.net. Be sure to check it out. It's informative. He has MP3s, different classes, courses, and everything that... and all that he's doing to educate you and yours. So please go ahead and check that out. Russ, this is a short segment as we close up this hour, getting ready for hour two. But what are some indicators of someone who is programmed?
Sure. Well, in as far as them finding out, because in our work with all of them, I believe that half of all of them out there are intact. And Sean, what I mean by that is that they don't even know yet. They're created with the sub-personalities of programming with the idea that the upfront person is to be amnesic. They're created so the upfront person does not know. So that when a handler or a coven member or a military handler would give a trigger code, the sub-personality that is programmed and trained to respond to it will pop up, pushing the main person down, and they'll do the task, whatever they're tasked to do. Now, how do they know? Part of the issue of them learning, you know, figuring out what's going on with them, they begin to hear voices inside, conversations inside their head. When they're younger, they think it's all normal until they realize most people don't have that. So they have conversations in their head. They know there's other voices in there. Second, they might begin to have dreams and flashes of really horrific, well, rituals and really horrific things. They don't know where they've come from. A third thing, indicator, would be they begin to realize they're missing time. Maybe they get off of work at 4 o'clock, they're driving home, but they don't get home until 8 o'clock. And it's only a half-hour drive, and they don't know where they were. They don't know what happened in the last 3.5 hours. Or they went to bed in their pajamas. They woke up the next morning. They're in their blue jeans. They got, you know, cuts on themselves. They're tired, and they, you know, they don't know how they, you know, what occurred. Missing time is a big element, because when another personality is triggered to come up, the main person is down and is not cognitive. They don't know what's going on, so they're really missing the time. The person that has been brought up to do shooting, to do a ritual, to go do something else, may do something for 2, 3, 4 hours, then go down, the main person comes back. They have no memory, but the memory is down in there somewhere. Now, in observing individuals like this, that's why I say in observing program shooters, in my observation, I believe the VTech shooter was programmed. I believe that Holmes in Colorado and Jared in Arizona had some parts programmed that did what they did. Mm-hmm. Now, that's the observation. In programmed individuals, multiple, there's an issue with the eyes. It takes somebody a while to really observe this and know this. You know, if you work with, you know, those who have programmed subparts, you'll be able to see this and observe this over time. You can detect if you realize. I mean, if you as a husband or wife has a spouse that all of a sudden you don't know where they're at on the weekends for a couple hours, or phone calls come in and you answer and they hang up all the time. You know, or you begin to notice that your spouse seems to be, you know, switches or completely becomes another person. Then there's some indicators that you have, you know, you tissue down inside. But those in every single SRA, multiple, whether military or pure coven, the same elements of program personalities, specified programming for either assassins or shooters or whatever.
That's interesting. You said issues with the eyes, which is ties into something I want to bring up in the next hour, the movie Eyes Wide Shut. Plus, when we come back from this break, in hour number two, I want you to share some stories. You've been in some dangerous situations throughout your 30-plus years in this field. My guest, Russ Dizdar, his website, shatterthedarkness.net. We're going to be back 6 minutes past the top of the hour with hour two on Floor of Wisdom. We'll be right back. Motivated, hip hop motivated, flow of wisdom on the mic with Sean Anthony. Motivated.